Hello, we are UMD Loop, the University of Maryland's URC competition team. Our 40 members come from engineering, space systems, and computer science backgrounds, and our team has previously competed in Hyperloop and tunnel boring competitions. We've been hard at work over the last year and are excited to share our very first rover with you.
Our chassis utilizes a Form 6061 aluminum sheet metal construction, chosen for its structural integrity, lightweight, and reliable internal organization. Our design includes internal mounts for custom electronics, external mounts for the radio and antenna, and a multi-purpose fixture to attach the sides and arm modules. To design our suspension system, we conducted a trade study, including a literature review and dynamic train simulations. Using a MATLAB script, we optimized linkage dimensions and even weight distribution. Our final design is a differential rocker bogey suspension, with aluminum linkages capable of traversing uneven terrain and obstacle heights up to 30 centimeters. Our suspension utilizes pneumatic wheels with an aggressive lug tread to ensure traction over a variety of terrain. Our brushed DC drive motors incorporate an internal gearbox to provide 9 Newton meters of torque, allowing our rover to navigate obstacles and climb slopes up to 45 degrees.
The arm and drive subsystems consist of associated CAN-controlled motor drives. The science module consists of a subsystem controlled PCB, fluorometer boards, stepper motor controllers, and a centrifuge motor controller. We are using STM32, H7, and G4 series microcontrollers to make application-specific boards such as the science and redstone PCBs, allowing for a more elegant electrical system.
We use the CAN protocol to provide robust communication between different parts of the rover's onboard systems. The onboard system's distributed nature allows for significant software modularity and code reuse.
Two Rocket M900 radio modules are used for communication over the 900 MHz band. One is mounted at the ground station with a directional grid antenna, with the other mounted on the rover with an omnidirectional antenna. Using ROS2's communications protocols, we can manage rover operations remotely, with up to 1 mile line of sight distance between the ground station and rover.
To confirm the accuracy and precision of our motor control, we drove a 14-inch long pipe using our brushless DC motors and 101 gearboxes to measure the accuracy of the system to less than a degree. Using the smaller scale arm, we were able to confirm the functionality of our 101 cycloidal gearbox with our high-speed brushless DC motors to generate the calculated torque needed to lift the arm. In addition, we confirmed the functionality of our parallel linkage grippers' ability to not just grasp objects, but also hold them firmly in order to lift them off the ground. With the knowledge and confidence gained in the fundamentals of our system, we are now developing our 6-degree freedom meter-long arm. We will utilize metal versions of our 101 and 40-to-1 gearboxes, enabling our system to lift 7 kilograms. We expect 2 millimeter precision and 98 newtons of clamping force at the gripper. The design also prioritizes dexterity by having a 3-degree of freedom arm that reaches a height of 0 to 1.5 meters and spans 1.2 meters.
Our soil collection, life detection, and auger systems are housed in our fully formed aluminum science box, designed to be lightweight, configurable, and fully waterproofed in the case of internal spillage. All instruments are deployed on a custom lowering platform actuated with dual lead screws. Our coaxial collection and mixture system uses a servo-actuated scoop to collect regolith, which leads to a connected internal mixing chamber. A unique internal geometry ensures no spillage during processing. A peristaltic pump then feeds a buffer solution into the scoop, which is spun to homogenize the mixture. Using a system of check valves, the same pump then transports the mixture to a cuvette within our custom centrifuge containing pre-prepared aliquots of fluorometric assays, which derivatize peptides and inorganic pyrophosphate in the sample. The centrifuge then separates the denser regolith from the rest of the sample so that our custom fluorometer can read the supernatant. To collect the subsurface sample, a sleeved auger is deployed from the lowering platform to first excavate through 10 centimeters of soil, then collect and deposit the subsurface sample into an easily removable collection box. The collection box incorporates a servo-actuated lid that, along with the auger casing, ensures no cross-contamination with the surface soil. Past the 10-centimeter subsurface depth, two parallel capacitive plates are used to determine soil moisture content by reading the permittivity of the soil. An NTC thermistor ensures accurate temperature measurement at the subsurface depth.
For the autonomous navigation missions, we compute a global path from the ground station using elevation data with 1 meter resolution. We use the Pixhawk GPS module with real-time kinematic positioning, using the ground station's known location to globally localize the robot. Pre-computed global path is sent to the rover, then local pathfinding run on the rover is used to adjust the rover's path in response to new obstacles the rover detects. We use the Z2i camera for local pathfinding as well as detecting Arugo tags and objects. The Z2i is a stereo camera which provides both depth and high resolution RGB data. We use the depth data from the Z camera to detect and avoid obstacles, and we use YOLO V8 for object detection and OpenCV for Iruko tag detection.
We are excited and prepared to compete in our first University Rover Challenge. Over the next months, we plan to test and refine our rover under simulated mission conditions. See you in Utah!